Hello everyone, my name is Eugene First, and in this video we are going to solve this question, alright? It's exercise 12 from y is equal to mx plus c textbook, alright? So it says the diagram below shows the rhombus KLNN. The coordinates of K and the coordinates of M are given. It's -1, -1, and +6, +6. The equation of line KEL is given as 4y is equal to 3x - 1, and the equation of line ELM is given as 3y is equal to 4x - 6. Alright, so this is the diagram, and in this video we are only going to solve A and B. So A part says calculate the coordinates of vector L, and the B part says calculate the length of the side of the rhombus. So as we have seen earlier in our first video or video number 9, we have learned that for you to find the coordinates of any vertex, you need to solve two equations simultaneously, and we are going to solve these two equations simultaneously. So we just go up and start solving it. Alright, so these are the two equations. As you can see, this variable y, they don't have the same number in front, nor the variable x, they don't have the number, the same number in front. So what we need to do, we need to make sure that these three, these two numbers are the same, or these two numbers are the same, so we can eliminate one variable. So to get started, let's multiply this by 3, and we multiply the second equation by 4. Now the question is, why are we multiplying the first one by 3 and the second by 4? It's because we want to have number 12 here and also number 12 here. So 3 times 4 is 12, and 4 times 3 is 12. So in the next line, I am going to write down the expanded form of these two equations. If you can just allow me to go down, and paste this word down here. So if I can bring this one here, okay, and then if I do the 3 times 3, that would be 9. The same, and they are all positive. So what we need to do, we need to make one of them negative. So what we need to do is to say the first equation minus the second equation. So we just put a minus sign in front here, all right so that we say first equation minus the second equation. So let's see what will happen. So for that, I think I need to insert so 9y minus 16y, that will give us negative 7y, right? Because a small number minus a big number will give us a negative answer. Alright, and then at 12 minus 12, that will give us 0. Let's put the zeros there. And negative 18 minus negative 4, that will be negative 14. So this is like you're saying minus 18 plus 4, because negative and negative become a plus. So it's like a negative 18 plus 4, and that gives us minus 14. So if we simplify this further, this is what we'll end up with. Alright, so this side will still be 7y. On the side, we only have now minus 14. All right, so after what we need to do, we need to divide both sides by 7. So let's divide both sides by 7. So we insert the next line, and then the next line, what we need to do, we make this a fraction. We make that a fraction. number divided by a negative number, that turns out positive. So again, we paste. So we have just a positive 1 here, and a negative number divided by a negative number, again negative 40 divided by negative 7 will give us positive 2. So we found the y coordinate or the y part, which is positive 2. So what do we need to do? We take one of these two equations. We'll take a small one here. So we can just put it in here and then look for the x part. So instead of having the y here, open up the bracket, we close the bracket, and let's put in positive 2. Alright, let's see what will happen. So in the next line, so I'm going to remove the bracket. Let's apply both mass. Let's apply both mass here. Okay, this will become now 6. Positive 6, and then I call it like 10, so the 6 has to come this side. So, okay, so you can allow me to copy this instead of typing it again. Paste it here, and that's gonna be positive 6, and this one will not be here anymore. Alright. Simplify further. 6 plus 6 will give us 12. So now we have 12 is equal to 4x. Alright. And then in the next line, so we need to divide the x by 4. Because we want to get to the 4 on the left hand side. So if you can allow me to do that, just put a 4 here. I divide both sides by 4, put the 4 down here. I do the same thing to this term. I divide by 4. Okay, 4 divided by 4. That will be x, 1x, and then 12 divided by 4. That will be 3. Let's see. So this will be x. This will be 3. So the coordinates for this for point L, so L has these coordinates of positive 3 and positive 2. That is the answer of part A. Alright, let's move over to part B. So we can get just get to the question and see what it says. Calculate the length of the side of the rhombus. So we want to find the distance of KL, LM, MN, or NK. These four distances or the four lengths, they are all the same because it's a rhombus. A rhombus, all the four sides are equal. So to do this, we need to apply the theorem of Pythagoras that says the distance between two points is given by this formula. Alright. So now that we have these coordinates, we can either use point K and L, or we can use point L and N. So let us use point K. L. Right. So if you just go up and push this bar up as well. So we want to find distance K. So before that, let's write down the coordinates. K has these coordinates. The coordinates of K are minus 1, minus 1. Those are the coordinates of K. And the coordinates of L, we just found them now. It's positive 3, positive 2. Alright, so what we do? We can go down and get the formula using up and get this formula. Now you copy it, you go up so we don't have to retype it. It's not going to take some time, so we paste it here. We start substituting, so y2 minus y1. So let's say this is point y. Point 2, alright, and this is point 1. So y2, it's positive 2, and y1, it's negative 1, alright, and x2 is positive 3, and y 1 is negative, when x1 is negative 1, so it will add. Okay, so it's y2 minus y1 x2 minus x1. Now to simplify that, so you can also copy all this and allow me to control this. Video, please remember to like, remember to share, remember to subscribe, so that next time I will produce a video, you'll be informed. Thank you so much for watching, and I would like you to try part 0 and 1 and 2, so that when we do it in our next video, you can put your answers with the answer that you have worked out together. Thank you so much, and see you next time.